Hi, welcome to ESP32 Starter Kit from SunFounder's. This is the best ESP32 learning kit from SunFounder's. It has this ESP32 microcontroller, which has built-in Wi-Fi and Bluetooth. This board can do everything Arduino Uno can do or many other Arduinos can do, plus extra more features. Because we have Wi-Fi and Bluetooth, the possibilities are endless. You can get connected to the cloud or do the control or read information or values via your mobile device or your desktop or over the cloud from a far location. It comes with a camera extension kit where you can stream the video over Wi-Fi either through the cloud or to your network. And also it comes with micro SD card where you can save images on the micro SD card, or you can write from the device any information, log the information on the device and read it back. You can power the board using this included 18650 lithium battery, and it has built-in charger where you can connect micro USB and charge the battery. The kit comes with 300 This is ESP32 development board, microcontroller, Wi-Fi and Bluetooth. The actual chip is this piece which has been soldered, and different manufacturers are offering it at different size. Sometimes even you might get it at this larger size, but the actual chip is this one. This is the antenna, and we will connect micro USB here to program this. So what this does is it can read input pins, like voltage or signal or pulses, or it can output signal or pulses, and this can be used with the temperature sensor, with a speed sensor, with motion sensor, with different kind of sensor, motor control, display, camera, whatever you think can be controlled with electric signal, this would be able to do it in most cases. This can do everything that Arduino Uno can do. Using Arduino IDE, we can program ESP32 the same way as we do other Arduino like Arduino Uno. But this has much more capability. Even in terms of size, it's small, but it has Wi-Fi, which Arduino, majority of Arduino boards, they do not have it. It has Wi-Fi and Bluetooth. Using Wi-Fi and Bluetooth, we can send the information over the Wi-Fi to a remote device like your mobile device or your computer, or to the cloud, so we can report temperature, motion of something, a burglar alarm, door opens, robotic arm does something. So we can do a lot of cool projects with this. SunFounder has provided this extension board where we can insert this on the board, and we can easily connect our devices via this terminals with a screw or a direct connection terminals. And here you can insert micro SD card to read from micro SD card or write to it. And this is the camera that you can connect to this point. And this camera also comes with the kit where you can connect and stream the video over Wi-Fi. Over Wi-Fi, either on our device or computer, or if you have a cloud subscription, you can watch it over the cloud. They have included also a battery. This is a lithium 18650 battery where we can connect this to the terminal, and the device can be turned on easily without a power adapter or the battery. And when you connect it via micro USB, this battery can be charged. There is a built-in charger where you can charge this battery and power the device as well. When we want to program this, we will connect the connector to this terminal and program the device. In order to work with this board with Arduino, you need to install Arduino IDE, a free software. This is arduino.cc website. I'm on arduino.cc. When you arrive here, click on software. And on the download, you will see Arduino IDE. Right now, the version is 2.2.1. By the time you watch this video, it might change, but does not matter. From the right, you select your operating system. For Windows 10 or newer, select the top one, or MSI installer or ZIP, whichever you prefer. For Linux or Mac, just select the operating system. I'm just selecting this one. It asks for the donation. Just click or just download. And they will ask for your email. Enter your email and confirm the privacy. And if you want to receive special deals or commercial offers, check that. Otherwise, just download. Then click on the file to open it. You have no choice but to agree with the term. Click next. Accept the security warning. And again, agree. Accept whatever is the installation path. Once the installation is completed, the checkbox is already checked. Just click finish. You might get a lot of warning. Every warning that you see displaying, accept them all and accept so this can get connected. Sometimes I ask for network connectivity and security warning. You have no choice but to accept it. For example, this one, I'm accepting it, and this one, accepting it. It's installing a lot of library and code that is needed. So Arduino IDE have been now installed. This is just simple, plain installation. Now I closed Arduino. To open it, click on Start and just type ARD Arduino and you will see it here. These are the downloaded files. Do not click on that. Click on this. And this is now Arduino IDE. I can click here to go full screen. Now let's get familiar ourselves with Arduino IDE. Anytime if you need to look at that version, just look at the top or click on Help, About, and it will tell you the version that you have installed on your machine. We have here file menu with certain options, which I'm going to go through some of them. Edit, Sketch, Tool, Help. From here, we will select our board. When we are working with a board, we must select it from here. And when we write our code, the code that you write, we click here to verify it. It will go and run. If there is any error, it will tell you. For example, right now it says fully qualified board. Board is not selected. So we can select our board and then go. So the first thing, let's select our board. Click on Tools, Board, and Board. From here, let's say if you select Arduino Uno, it has been selected and there is nothing in the code, but let's just click. So indexing and everything, and it's done. So this is now done. And this button is to upload the code to your board. At the bottom here, we can select and see our own code that we have, sketches. Here we select different boards or add boards if we want. And from here, we can select library and search library that we want. And this is for debugging to see the value or information. And from here, we can just search. Anytime, just click again, it will disappear. To save this code that is on the screen, click File and then Save. And here, name it, for example, test one or whatever you want. Now this has been saved. This icon on the right side is serial monitor, and this is called serial plotter. If I click on this, the serial monitor is displayed here and some information will be displayed. We can click again and it will disappear. You can click on File, Preferences, and here there are a lot of preferences that you can set. For example, this text size is 14. you can put, for example, 20, an automatic scale 100%, and then the light, the theme, for example, if you want to work with dark, that's a dark theme. You can select that. Let's go again back to preferences. And here it has auto save. And if you want to save always the files in a specific location, for example, if I select a board, I'm creating a folder called if I select this, anytime I save, it will go directly to this location without browsing or any hassle. Once the installation is finished, we can see the examples by clicking on File, Examples, and here we have tons of examples available for us. For example, if I click on hover over Basic, we see all these codes. Each is a project. If I go on Digital, these are projects. Analog, these are projects, and so forth. So they are available. If I go on Basic, for example, Blink, this is the Blink code that is available. In order for Arduino IDE or Arduino program to work with this ESP, we have to add the board to the program. For Arduino user, you will come here and we will copy this line. We need it. Select it, right click and select copy, and then come to Arduino IDE, go to File, Preferences, and here we have a path here. We can paste it here, but if you have a lot of other stuff, you can click and the bigger screen will open. And this is telling Arduino where to get the board information. Click OK and then click OK. That is done. Now from here we select, click on board, and we type ESP32. Make sure to select the one because this is the manufacturer, Espressif, and select install. Now this is installing the boards for this Arduino IDE. So it says successfully installed. Click and it will disappear. Now let's connect it for the first time. So we heard the sound. By default it should be installed. Now let's check it. Right click on the start menu here and go to Device Manager. From here select port and you will see USB serial CH340 and COM8. If you don't see it, then it means you need to install the driver because your system or computer is not supporting it. I will provide you a link so you can select and download the driver. Now we have to select the port for this so Arduino IDE can work with it. Now let's select the board. There are two ways. One way is to come here and click and search for the board. The other way is to click on Tools, Board, and then you can go for ESP32, which we just installed. And here you can see a lot of options available. And here it says ESP32 Dev Module. We will select this one, and the module is selected. The board is now selected. Now we have to select the port. From here we can select the port. Already it shows COM8. I'm not going to click on that. Let me show you another way. Tool, port, and here COM8 is shown here. So I can either click on this and you see it has been selected, or click in here. There are two ways to select the port, and now the port has been selected properly and we can upload the code to the board. This ESP32 can be programmed in multiple ways, but three ways are available with all the code and information. In this course, I'm going to Arduino, which is the easiest one for many people. But MicroPython is also very easy. If you're familiar with Python, then MicroPython will be a preferred method for you. Here are the list of projects available with all the code, wiring diagram, and information for you. So these are lists of components, and these are the projects for Arduino user. If you want to use Arduino, these are all projects and step-by-step instruction. About 50 projects up to here. If you are preferring MicroPython, then these are available projects for MicroPython. And if you want to play with Scratch, you can install picto blocks and write the code and program it. If you want to proceed programming with Arduino, here is an example, 2.2, fading an LED. It has been full explanation and wiring diagram and actual wiring on breadboard and the actual code that you can run and program. Every bit of code I've been explained here. Example page using MicroPython. If I scroll down, you see the wiring, you see the breadboard, how to connect it, and also here are the codes that it shows Python programming to turn the LED on and off. And every piece of the code I've been explained here. Now let's install the provided starter kit code. If we click on this, you will see the zip file, click open. It's located inside download. And let's right click and then extract all. I'm extracting it in this location because there is another folder inside it. I'm gonna delete it and it should be inside download. Click, wait for it. This has been closed and we have a folder or directory called ESP32 starter kit main. Double click and let me arrange it in order. And the code that we are working is called C. Inside the C folder, there are the code and libraries for us. So there is ESP32 library. There are two, one is audio, one is something else. So let's install these two. To install libraries, go to Sketch, Include Library, Add .zip Library. Click. Go to the download folder that we downloaded, and this was the zip. Let's delete it so we are not confused. And click on this to open it. Go to C, for example, Libraries, and then the first one, A2DP. Click and open. This has been installed. Let's install the other one. Library, Include Library, Add.zip Library. Again, back to download, ESP32 starter kit, C, library, and then audio. Click. Now this has been, it says processing and library installed. What happens and where is the library? If I click on file, examples, by the way, once you select the ESP32, now we can see the libraries available and the installed one. Click on file, examples, and here are the, these are all the basic that comes, and Arduino OTA. So these are ESP32 development code examples, and these are the two codes that we have installed. Under each title we have tons of codes.